Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome back to the channel, and today I'm gonna do a quick tutorial on how to get Ace Combat 6 working on PC through the Xenia emulator. I already have the folder right here with the emulator and the game, and for Ace Combat 6 in particular, we're gonna need a custom build of Xenia that was provided by, I don't remember his name right now, but I'm gonna put it on screen. And this custom build fixes most of the issues of Ace Combat 6 on Xenia. I'll put the link down below on the comment section of where you can download this custom build of Xenia. It doesn't come with the game, of course. You have to burn the copy from your own Ace Combat disc and put it on PC, just like I did with mine. I absolutely did not download this from the internet. The good thing about Xenia is that it's actually pretty easy to set it up and get it to work. After you download the emulator, all you gotta do is double click on Xenia.x. Gonna open this screen right here, and you just gotta click on File, Open, and then double click the game you want to play. It's simple as that. You don't have to download any like copyright file that is hard to find and put it on the phone or anything like that. Nothing like that. It's pretty much double click the Xenia.x and you're good to go. But for Ace Combat 6, you can increase the frame rate of this game. By default, Ace Combat 6 run on 30 FPS, right? If you want to change that, we have to go into the Xenia.config file right here. You can open this with the default notepad from Windows, just like I did it right here. So just double click it, gonna open this file. There's a bunch of settings, but we're gonna look for the VSync configuration. So if you wanna do this quick, just press Ctrl F on your keyboard. I already had typed it right here, VSync, and click on Find Next, and it's gonna take to this file right here. By default, this is gonna say vsync equals true, so you want to change this to false, and with that we're gonna unlock the frame rate of the game. But it's important to know that when you change this to false, the game is going to run on the refresh rate of your monitor. So if you have a monitor that is 60 hertz, the game is going to run on 60 FPS. It's gonna target that refresh rate. But if you have a, let's say for example, a monitor with 144 hertz or 165, the game is also going to try to match that refresh rate. And that is a problem on Ace Combat 6 because of how the game was coded back then. If you try to run on anything higher than 30 FPS, it will speed up the game. But from my own personal experience, if you keep it on 60 FPS, it will like speed up the cutscenes and the menus, but the actual gameplay will play fine with 60 with a few differences, like the acceleration on the aircraft, the deceleration, and the high G will become a little different than usual. They're gonna take, like, it will basically speed up the process of these things. So it's going to feel weird at first, but from my own personal experience, it doesn't take long for you to get used to it, right? It's different, but not really that much. But going anything higher than 60 in that case is going to speed up quite a bit, and it's gonna feel really, really weird. So I recommend that you keep it on 60. And if you do have a monitor that is higher than 60 hertz, you can limit the frame rate by going into the NVIDIA control panel, for example, and lock the frame rate at 60. But if you want another recommendation, I would recommend you to use Riva Turner's statistics server right here. This works for pretty much any application on Windows, including Xenia. And you pretty much just gotta add the .zx file, and then you go on frame rate limit and type 60 or whatever frame rate that is that your desire, right? This program right here has worked pretty well for me, and it works well for Xenia as well. After you've done this, of course, you have to save the settings you've made. So just click on File, Save, or just Ctrl S on your keyboard, right? And you're pretty much good to go right now. So just close this file, and now you can run Ace Combat 6 normally. Unfortunately, the audio bug that is occurring on missions, that is the soundtrack being duplicated on missions, is still occurring in this build of the emulator. So as of right now, there is no real fix for that, but it doesn't have any crashes or anything like that, so you can still play the game from beginning to finish with these settings. I'm going to leave you with a bit of gameplay right now so you can see how this looks on action. But anyway, thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you soon.
This is Commander Wind Hover of the 15th Squadron. The enemy is expanding its field of attack. Stay alert.
Rota 1, there's too many of them. Use your SP weapon.